Hello and welcome to F1 2022. We're going to be starting off our first episode of a My Team Career in the new, brand new, yes, I said new twice, now three times, F1 2022 game. We're going to have some fun with it. We are going to start right off as a newcomer. Custom season length. Or do we want to do the full season? Let's do the full season. It's a brand new game. We have plenty of time. Why not just use the whole brand new full season? Okay, we're just going to quickly go through all of our settings. Okay, we are going to do this again. Tacos. Nice. Now, Gamba Racing, we are back. So we need to sign a prime sponsor. Why are you still in that one?
Our primary sponsor will pay a sign and bonus to the team up front. This is vital to cover the early investments we need to make. They'll also provide valuable income. Each sponsor has a goal they want the team to achieve. If we hit that goal, the sponsor will pay.
Okay. So we got Xenom Dynamics. Earn 15 constructor points. Get 3.8 mil. Echo as a team achieved 2 point finishes during the season for 3.96 mil. XXY finished.
Sorry. I don't have an answer for that.
Oh, shut up, Echo. XXY finished 8th or better in constructors, 3.63 million. That's a sad one. You have a better signing bonus. The weekly bonus is shit, and the gold bonus is shit. 5 constructors championship points. RGB, 10th or better in constructors, get 2.42 million. I think our best option is Xenom Dynamics. We just need 15 constructor points.
Fantastic, now we've got a budget to work with. Our car won't be,
I think we can get 15 constructor points in our first season. Hope.
We need both performance and durability from our power units, but we also need to balance the books. We're going to have a lot of other areas to invest in.
Remember when Ferrari was supposed to have the best reliability and, best reliability engine?
We almost have all the key parts for that team.
Holy.
We still need a team. These are the drivers available to be your first teammates. They have all their own strengths and weaknesses, so consider everything when deciding who to pick. Drivers earn acclaim based on their performances. When a driver earns enough acclaim, they will level up. The higher a driver's level, the more acclaim they will earn for their current team. And remember, the faster the team levels up, the faster our income will increase. The higher a driver's experience, the more resource points are earned to spend on vehicle upgrades. Racecraft is the driver's skills to effectively complete overtakes.
I can't skip, guys.
pace describes the driver's ability to set a competitive lap. Focus represents the driver's current form and state of mind. Rating is a summary of the driver's overall skill.
Yeah, we didn't absolutely fuck it.
Looks like we can afford this power unit supplier and team. Go ahead and confirm it.
I'm not happy. Yes.
The greater the performance and durability. Looks like we can afford this power unit supplier and team. Go ahead and confirm it. Here are the drivers interested in joining our team. Looks like we can afford this power unit supplier and teammate. Go ahead and confirm if you have.
Wait, I can afford Oscar Piastri? Huh?
Looks like we can't afford this power unit supplier and teammate. Let's go into one of those and sign someone cheaper or try and find a sponsor. Looks like we can afford this.
So if we use the Merc engine, we can use Oscar Piastri. But Ferrari have the best engine. Red Bull and Merc are the same. I think there's only the Red Bull powertrain dirty here. Because those Red Bulls are feckin' rapid. Want Oscar Piastri, or do we want?
Looks like we can afford this power unit supplier and team.
Okay.
Hello, folks, and welcome to this, a very special edition of Paddock Pass. We're here at the headquarters of Formula One's newest team for an exclusive first look at what they will be bringing to the sport. It's always an exciting moment to welcome a new team onto the grid. However, what makes this occasion a little more special is how strikingly different the cars are this year. Yep, the long-awaited new regulations are finally here, and with them, the start of the next era of Formula One. The 2022 season ushers in a change of direction to the regulations aimed at promoting closer racing. With new aero additions in the form of swooping front and rear wings, along with the new eye-catching 18-inch low-profile tyres that push tyre technology to the limit. So then, the question remains as to whether this team can grasp the opportunity before them with both hands and lead the charge against the rest of the paddock. We'll find out soon enough, as the new season is just about to begin. But first, let's see the unveiling of the team's car and meet the owner of the brand new Formula One team.
Wait, where? The fuck? Are you doing car reveal? Dun 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 dun. Sorry, music over, I'm not getting it.
Well, first of all, thanks so much for inviting us here today. It's been wonderful to see behind the scenes. As you might expect, I've got about a million questions, so let's jump straight in. It's been a long time since we last saw a team owner take their own car onto the track, and the sport's changed enormously in the intervening years. How are you going to handle the responsibilities of both managing and driving for a Formula One team?
Okay, nothing is easy. Nothing easy is worth doing, and for the challenges like this. this isn't about me, it's about my team. I'm behind them 100%. Together we're unstoppable. Well, life's been a lot of work, there's even more to come, but I wouldn't have taken on the task if I couldn't believe in myself and my team. Which one? Let's do this one.
Let's talk about your teammate. Now, it's clear they're excited to have signed with you, but tell me, What is it that you think they bring to the team?
I was saying they can do on paper and a lot of potential in them. I was finding the right fit for our team. They understand that we're new and appreciate the opportunity of providing the skills that really suit their team. It was tough getting to understand with their team. This one.
So you've obviously been putting a lot of work into the car. I know it's early days, but how do you expect it to feel out there?
Making the car as responsive as possible is one of their main goals. Give us advantage in getting going into corners. We're focusing heavily on maximizing our traction out of corners. Sim data is looking good. We went on until we're on track. Chassis balance is incredible. This one.
Most of the other teams.
Nice aero.
Years of experience in Formula One. Where do you see the opportunities to make those vital performance gains you need to put you within reach of the other cars?
Okay, this era has brought a lot of complexity into the power unit, but we've found plenty of room to innovate our ERS system. Fuel loads are the key to reducing the weight of the car. Going to be tough. Feel a better picture after the first race. After fresh pair of eyes. A fresh pair of eyes can find a solution other teams haven't. Reducing drag. We like ERS.
Success this season is going to come down to whether you can take positions from the other drivers. What is it about your car that's going to give you that edge in those battles?
Overtaking is all but power, so we've been working hard to get our performance out of the power unit. Really streamlined car, top speed on straights. F1 isn't just a race, the whole season. We're stress testing, and a incredibly light car has both top speed and through corners to help our chassis.
Finally, with so many specialist departments working together here at your headquarters, and with such an important deadline coming up, who's getting that coveted teacher's gold star?
Aero.
Well, thank you so much for your time. It's been wonderful to get an insight from you, and of course to see around the headquarters. Thank you for today. Really appreciate it, and thank you all at home for watching as well. We'll see you very soon.
Months of rumor and speculation all come
Straight
to an
elements,
end today
Bonchek.
As we return to racing for the opening event of what promises to be an enthralling season. Welcome along then to round one of this year's Formula One World Championship. Formula One returns to the desert today on this exceptional 3.36-mile circuit. 15 corners provide plenty of overtaking opportunities, and it could be a strategic race this one, with Sakhir notorious for eating up the rear tyres. Watch out for drivers managing their rubber at some point during the Grand Prix. Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. A fantastic effort from Charles Leclerc yesterday, and it's put him on pole. And Max Verstappen lines up alongside. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Sainz, Russell, Sergio Perez, and Hamilton. Ocon, Bottas, Fernando Alonso, and Mick Schumacher. Tsunoda. A new season then, a clean slate where anything could happen. Anthony Davidson is with me today as once again we get another year of Formula One underway.
We're into those tense few minutes before the first race then. Everyone's a little bit nervous about reliability. They haven't been running in the hot, turbulent wake of other cars in practice, and they've not been pushing at 100% for long durations. Let's hope no one has to deal with any nasty surprises.
First race of the first season. I forgot to do race strategy.
Formation lap gets underway, and every driver will be looking to settle in for the race ahead, making sure that their car is ready for the battle once the lights go out. As the cars come back towards the grid to line up for the start of the race, each driver will be wanting to get the best start they possibly can, and they'll be hoping to finish today's race on the podium, failing that, within the points.
Lights out. Right, clean in the throttle. Let's build the revs.
And we are off in the first season. Oh, I'm ready to climb with our teammate. Oh no, I cut the curb! Shit! Ah, we made overtakes too, we were 15th. God damn it. A little wide there.
DRS will be enabled this lap. You can use it when you're within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone.
I'm slow through that corner still. This hairpin. Well, I managed to close the gap by about 4 seconds. Unfortunately, we're still last place.
pit window, you're going
to Danny Rick's in the pits.
Might kind of box this lap. So, don't know what my strategy is. It's a forward corner.
Okay, we can take you this lap.
In the lane and ready to perform their magic on the car. They're going to be aiming to achieve the fastest pit stop time possible.
Look after these tyres now and want to finish the race in this compound.
Oh, Pog, we're still ahead of Danny Rick. Totally not hitting the wrong buttons there, that totally fucked my outlap. Aw, you bitch. Not a great lap, but we're still ahead of Ricciardo. How? Yeah, it's down to 5.
Coming in for his stop now.
Where would I drive here? I'll fuck rid of your ass. Shit. Probably went a little wide there.
Okay, clear.
Lap 9 of 14. Okay, 8 seconds back of Oscar Piastri. Only 3 back of Latifi at the moment. Still trying to claw back into this race from our lap 1 spin.
Laps of fuel remaining. 1 second.
Not a great T1.
Gap to the car in front is 3.4 seconds.
We're not really catching it, unfortunately. Oh, I ran really deep there. Wait, Sainz is in the pits. The fuck?
Fuck our ERS is crap.
Make the corner. Too low. Shay got too low again. Going into that corner too late.
Keep managing your tires, manage your tires.
shit in hell.
One lap of fuel remaining.
11 to 5 on lap 9. Denny Rick going away from me.
Okay, there's been an incident on track resulting in loose debris. Fortunately, the marshals have managed to clear it up in time, and there are so far no plans for a safety car.
What the fuck happened there?
Green flag. Gap ahead is 2.4 seconds.
I can take that one corner really wide. Oh, Sainz, you bitch. Fuck, we should have had Sainz.
Today, Ant, that gave them the edge over the competition.
Well, this was a real team victory. They put together a solid strategy to the
Ferrari are at it again. An excellent performance at today's Grand Prix, and they're certainly a team that know what they're doing out there.
Should have been fucking higher than that.
So let's review the driver's standings. Charles Leclerc's points today take him to the top of the championship standings. Well, after an incredible day of racing, who was your driver of the day, Ant?
Nicholas Latifi gets my vote today.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. And Red Bull take over as championship leaders. Well, what an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.
Well, that'll do it for Episode 1 of our F1 2022 solo career mode. Stay tuned as we'll have episode 2 shortly with our second and third races of our career.